I'm John McGrath. I'm a producer for Flatland at Kansas City PBS. And today, Art House brings you the amazing short documentary, Love, Barbara. Love, Barbara is the new film by Brydie O'Connor. And Art House sat down and talked to Brydie not just about this film, but her other accomplished works and her winning the first ever Teri Rogers Film Grant.
I wrote this letter for Barbara. Hi, honey girl. That's the name you called me, and I miss hearing it.
Love, Barbara is my most recent film. It's actually a documentary. It's a documentary short. It's about the legacy of lesbian experimental filmmaker Barbara Hammer through the lens and love of her partner of over 30 years, Florrie Burke. So I wanted to explore, you know, the impact and the, you know, pioneering kind of history of Barbara Hammer, who passed away in 2019, but I was fortunate enough to, you know, I was researching her work back when I was an undergraduate. I was researching her early filmography from the 1970s, which is oftentimes regarded as her, you know, most iconic work. You know, she had over 80 films, and she just documented her life and her body and her surroundings. And she wanted to put a life on screen that she didn't see there before. You know, she had split from her husband and she came out as a lesbian in the late 1960s. And she wanted to kind of create this marker of history and this lifestyle that she was living. She just felt like there was no authentic representation of the life that she was leading in an art form. So, you know, she used kind of experimental form to reflect this life that felt, you know, outside of the status quo. And I think, you know, I admire her so much as an artist, and I admire her work, but I also admire her ethos. And I think it's a huge part of, you know, what has become a huge part of my ethos as a filmmaker is be a voice of something that I feel like isn't on screen, something that, you know, a way in which I want to be reflected on screen, or I want to see kind of an identity or a lifestyle on screen that, you know, that isn't necessarily there.
First of all, how's it going out there swimming with the whales?
It is through, you know, it's driven by, you know, archival, but also footage that I filmed with Florrie Burke, Barbara's partner, and the executor of the estate. So it goes through kind of this really specific moment in time where Florrie is, you know, in her home during the pandemic, going through all of these things that Barbara left behind. And Barbara left, you know, she was so prolific. She created this huge archive and this really organized archive. And, you know, some of it went to a formal archive at a university. Some of it went to the academy, and a lot of it left, you know, was what she left at home with Florrie. And so we kind of follow this process of Florrie discovering, you know, this work and these letters and these, you know, films that she had never seen. So it was really special. I think it ties into my, you know, DNA as an artist. I want to put, you know, lesbians on screen and in this way that I haven't seen before. And I think that Barbara is a perfect example of that. You know, her whole life was, you know, trying to authentically represent herself and represent the ideas that were important to her, and the things that mattered most to her. Friends of Dorothy, it's a short documentary. It's about city-dwelling LGBTQIA folks who return to their hometowns in the Midwest, kind of navigate the place where they grew up for the first time now as openly queer folks. So I filmed in Kansas City, I filmed in Iowa, and, you know, and in Kansas and Missouri side. So I just kind of wanted to chart this experience of kind of settling back in to the Midwest now, kind of after having, you know, this identity shift.
Because I don't think I would have liked to buzz cut on myself. Too much for you. Too much for me.
It was just observational and you know, an opportunity to kind of reflect on what this time means and how it feels to be, you know, occupying this space that you know, you spent your formative years in, but now, you know, kind of with a new and more authentic understanding of yourself.
I think he has a lot of guilt. He's Catholic.
It was the first time I really was filming something not knowing what it would be necessarily.
Welcome everyone.
So Going Steady is my first film ever. It's about a woman's wild imagination of the relationship she truly desires in 1950s Kansas. And it kind of follows this day, this imaginative day that, you know, a young woman has and, killing her boyfriend and turning him into her girlfriend and taking him on, you know, the most perfect day in, you know, around her hometown. It's silly, it's fun, it's a little campy. And it was, you know, my first go at a scripted piece. I wrote it, I directed it, I produced it. So it's one of my favorite projects still to this day.
Daddy.
I made Going Steady because, you know, I was really interested in kind of placing queerness back into the history of the Midwest. I wanted to kind of talk about queerness in the place that I'm from, in kind of, you know, in a way to kind of create a lineage for me and the place that I, you know, was in and the place I grew up.
The thing about this business of atomic science is that radioactive.
I think in queer films, there's oftentimes, you know, an impulse to kind of focus on what's hard about being queer and coming out and what, you know, kind of the hardships that we face in being queer and, you know, in my case, being a lesbian. And I think that I wanted to create something that was, like you said, lighthearted and, you know, is relatable and accessible to queer folks and non-queer queer folks alike.
We should be making the most of our time.
One of the chemical engineers at the atomic project here at Oak.
Let's get married.
So I kind of wanted to blend, you know, my tastes and my interests as, you know, a viewer with also, you know, my intention to kind of insert queerness into these genres and these spaces that I was really interested in and that I wanted to just see a reflection of myself in these, in this kind of genre. And you know, I was playing a little bit with the, you know, effects of repression and, you know, how, what it would actually be like, you know, the pressure that, you know, a young woman might have felt in the 1950s. And what do you do with your desires if they're not, you know, accepted by, you know, the world around you? And this was just kind of an exploration of something that took that repression to, you know, the furthest lengths.
What's the future for Brydie O'Connor? Where do you see yourself and what are your hopes and aspirations and dreams?
I'm so excited to be making a new scripted short film that is being funded through a grant that I received through the Teri Rogers Grant. And of course, it's such an honor to be recognized in this way. But secondly, I think, you know, learning more about Teri Rogers and who she was and her impact that she had in the Kansas City film world, I think I feel so thrilled to be kind of following her in her footsteps and to, you know, have someone like her, even though I wasn't, you know, didn't have the pleasure of meeting her in person, just, you know, having this person who left such a mark and was such a trailblazer in her own respect. I am so grateful to, you know, to you and to the Teri Rogers Grant Committee and to ArtsKC and to all of the support that I've received. It's called Sasperumpit. It's, you know, it's in pre-production right now. It's about a community college women's tennis team. And, you know, when the star of this team breaks her offbeat good luck charm, she has to face herself on the court. She has to face who she really is. And, you know, it turns out that her desires actually, you know, lie in her teammate. You know, the grant is making this next film possible. So it's supporting kind of the next direct step in my career. So I'm really excited to return to the scripted space. I'm 27 and it's a forever process to kind of continue understanding and, you know, my place in the world. And I do that through making films.
Many ask if doing all this is hard for me. No, it is a great gift. It keeps you close.
I hope to talk about queerness in whatever form that is. I am a lesbian filmmaker. That is my perspective and my life. And that's my direct surroundings. That's how I view the world. That's, you know, that's what informs my worldview. And I think it's so important to me to explore queerness in whatever context and whatever, you know, whatever form that comes out. It's just what I'm interested in. It's just reflective of how I view the world, what I'm thinking about throughout the day. That's definitely the lens through which I view the world. So it's the lens through which I view my art as well.
I love you and miss you, my beloved Barbara Hammer. Your girl.
Hey, I'm John McGrath. I'm the host for Art House. If you like this video, just click the subscribe button. And when you do that, you're going to be locked into everything film in Kansas City.